Welcome everybody, I'm Cobra, and I have the Samsung Galaxy Fold right here. If you know me, you know I've been eyeing this since it was first introduced. I love the idea behind this, the concept behind this. I don't love that price, but being someone that's deeply into new technology, pushing the envelope, I had to get my hands on this. Initially, it reminded me of one of my favorite feature phones, not smartphones, the LG Envy or VX9800. It was very similar to this phone. What made it unique was the form factor, the keyboard. It was clamshell, but it opened up to a full QWERTY keyboard. This phone reminds me of that. The way it looks, the way it feels, bigger screen, of course, and full screen on the inside, of course, but I had to get my hands on this. Now, even though lots of people said it wasn't worth the money and they had their reasons why, I had to find out for myself. But the first thing you'll notice is I'm making this video with a case on. Now, why? Because it is so fragile. It is too fragile in my opinion. If I'm not gonna keep this phone, it's gonna be simply because of how worried I am of damaging it. As soon as I got it, I looked at it, took a few pictures, and then I put this case on. It did come with this case. Now, the outside screen is small, but it's not too small. I'll show you an example when I start typing on that tiny keyboard, but that's the worst part when I have to type on the keyboard. But when I'm just searching the web and things like that, it's absolutely fine. So anyway, the size of it, it's pretty thick, it's pretty heavy. And it's really annoying when I have it wide open and I'm opening it up, I'm trying to hold it. I actually get tired of holding it because it's so heavy. But let me just talk about some of the main things about this phone, why you might want to get it. If you like me and you need something different in the tech game, this is definitely it. It does seem like a waste of space here on the front, but I can use pretty much everything I need to from this initial screen. Now, if I just bring up, let's go to DuckDuckGo, and let's say I want to type in a website. Let's go to Gizmodo. And look at that keyboard. It's pretty small, right? It's pretty small, and I got big thumbs. But if I just want to quickly look at something, I can quickly browse it. I did have to enlarge the font a little bit to help me out, but when you really get into an app, or if you get into a website, something you really want to read, then you just pop it open. Bam, and just like that. Look how fast that was. Now you can have it enabled to where you close it, it stays on the outside screen, but I just like that feeling of bam, and it's off. Here it is closed. Now, there's different ways you open it, of course. They have the face unlock, which works pretty well. Watch this. There it is, right? The face unlock, it doesn't work very well in dark lights, though. It's not like Face ID on the iPhone or on the Huawei Mate 30. And if you have sunglasses on, it doesn't work very well. So you have that side-mounted fingerprint sensor, and that's not the best either, because if you look here, you can see that with this case on, it's a little bit indented, so that top front lip kind of covers it. So you got to make sure your hand, first it has to be on, and you have to make sure your thumb gets right up in there, and then it works. But you know what, sometimes it doesn't trigger it. That's not the best feature. But I'm going back to things that you wanted this for, right? Reasons you wanted this. So you want to be out there, you want to be doing your thing, you're working on this little screen here, and you get tired of it, right? You get tired of looking at this little screen, you want to bust it wide open, there it is, bam. This is what you're getting this phone for. This huge, huge screen on the inside where you can just do your thing, right? I feel like you have a mini tablet in your hand. And I think it's the perfect size for, like, you know, reading websites and watching videos on the go. That crease right there, everybody talks about that crease. The one thing I can say is it seemed like the crease has gotten worse. I had it for about 28 hours. It seemed like the crease is getting worse. Not more noticeable, but of course if I hit the light on it, I notice it has a little more curvature than it did when I first had the phone. But that's my main concern. Like, I've been babying this phone. Even when I close it down here on the bottom, I see some people press it from right here. I don't do that. I press from the bottom, and there it is, right? So nice. There's a face unlock. So the main thing I want to say is some of the things about this phone that I really love is that display, is this form factor. The speakers are pretty good. They threw everything in with these cameras. It's like everything you will want in a phone, all wrapped into one. Everything you will want. A bit heavy, yeah. Very, very fragile. Now, I've been looking at this. I make sure my hands are clean every time I touch it. But you even see around the bezels, 28 hours. Even around the bezels, getting kind of messed up. And I did notice a little scratch. I don't know if it could pick up on it. Already right there. I don't know if you can see that, but already has a little scratch on it. And I'm like, man, I'm already babying this phone. And I actually had it in my pocket and I just jogged for a minute, just out of the blue, right? I started jogging and I was like, wait a minute, I can't run like that with this phone in my pocket. So if you have this phone, you really got to take care of it. And that's something that I'm a little worried about, especially because in the box. Now, I did hear about this. They did offer a $150 screen replacement. I was like, okay, you know, worst come to worst, in about a year or so, the screen gets pretty scratched up, I'll get it replaced for $150. But then I read this right here. If purchased before December 31st. So I'm like, dang, I got it two weeks too late or what? I mean, if I call them, can I, you know, talk about that, maybe negotiate it or something like that? But I don't know, but that kind of got me a little concerned too. So my main concern with this phone is the durability, like everyone says. And like on my iPhone, I don't use any case at all, right? I use a skin and a screen protector, sometimes no skin, but no case at all. I already threw this one on. Most phones I use cases. But this one is a thin case, which of course you want to keep that same form factor. But just touching the screen, like what if I have like a little grain of sand on my hand and I start swiping, right? So is it gonna get scratched up? I don't know, but that makes me kind of nervous. I'm just being honest, that makes me kind of nervous. But like I said, web browsing on here is a beauty. Look at that. Portrait, landscape. It is absolutely beautiful. That notch over here, everybody talks about, I don't really notice it. It doesn't really bother me. Just like the crease doesn't really bother me when I'm reading and things like that. I'm all right with that crease, actually. I'm just worried about scratching the screen, not really dropping it too much and breaking it, because I always get a more durable case. But just scratching this main display, that's my biggest concern. So if I hopped into YouTube, well, here we go with a Thomas DeLauer video. If you don't know Thomas DeLauer, fitness, healthy eating, things like that. But here it is. Now that notch is right here in the corner. And depending on how you hold it, you know, the notch is gonna be probably best down here in the corner. But I like to have the volume buttons at the top. But either way, here it is. Now, here it is in portrait mode. And I love this because the video size is perfect right here, where you can still scroll, you can still comment, you can read comments, you can read the description, everything is here, right in front of you while you're still watching the video. Now, even when I'm watching a video, sometimes I like to multitask, so you just swipe over from the right, and here's the different things you can do. All right, so let's say I bring DuckDuckGo again. Oh, it's not featured, it's not, here it is. So now here it is in the corner, right? Now you can have it there. If you turn it to landscape, there it is. You can scroll. Of course, I got the larger font, but I can also move it over right here and have it half of the screen. And then I could also add a third layer. Let's say I want to text or, you know, take a picture. There it is. So if I want to snap a picture, I can do so while scrolling or texting or doing whatever you want to do, right? And to close it out or look at that picture, you can look at it right there. Something like this is different. It's a game changer. I'm not trying to make this video too long, but I'll just give you my first initial experience with this phone. I'm liking it. I'm liking it a lot, but I am concerned. I am concerned. One little tiny scratch appeared in the corner already, and just how much I have to baby it. Feels pretty sturdy. I like how when I open it, see this right here, then snaps into place. Let me go ahead and let you see how the sound is.
In-game enhancement menu.
Speaker.
And those game-changing shoulder triggers. This really makes the Horizon display functional, not just for aesthetics. And one of the most fun and exceptional camera systems that I've ever used. Link to this cool case is in the description.
So as you can see, so far I'm having a lot of fun with this phone. I can't put it down. I'm doing all types of different things. This is just initial impressions. And like I said, 28 hours in, concerned about the durability, but not concerned with how much media consumption, multitasking I'm getting done with it. I really like it. It's fun. You know what I mean? It's fun. And that's what I think I was missing the most. Now the ROG Phone 2, fun. The Mate 30 Pro, fun. But this phone takes it to another level. What about that price though? What about that price? Yeah, that's up to you. That's up to you how much money is worth it. But I'll be the most worried about spending over $2,000 and it getting messed up, and then I have to spend how much to fix it, right? That's my biggest concern. But you know, back in the day, we didn't have Gorilla Glass on phones and things like that. But you know what? This is a different age, and this is a big old screen to get scratched up. You guys want to see without the case on it? Y'all want to see what it looks like? Y'all want to see? Let me see. Ooh. All right, that's enough of that. But you know, I'm going to break this phone down and really dive into it and let you know if it's worth that $2,000 price tag. All right, y'all. Hey, don't forget, Cobra told you.